In this video, we're going to look at how do we avoid shorting into the hole. Stay tuned. Hey traders, a very warm welcome to you. Okay, so first of all, let me explain what is shorting into the hole. It basically means somebody or you shorting when something is down very, very aggressively already, you're selling it and you're shorting into a hole which then pops straight back up. Because generally speaking, and I'm being very general here, there are conditions when it's fine to do this, but very often markets will bounce up aggressively when they're the very, very oversold conditions. Even in bear markets, you get really brutal short covering rallies, and shorting into the hole is the kind of thing where you're shorting intraday, looks really, really weak, right at the lows, you want to short it for more lows, and it just rips up and pushes back and it looks like you've really sold the low. So how do you avoid that kind of trade? Here's a couple of ideas for you. Right, number one is you use an indicator, an oscillator. And what I've put here is OS indicator. So use an oscillator like an RSI, a CCI, a Stochastic, whatever it may be on a time frame you're trading, and you never go short into an oversold condition. That will stop you shorting into the hole. It will stop you shorting at lows at the very least. Sure, all these things may well mean you miss trades, but in my experience, guys, and probably yours, it's better to miss a bunch of trades than to be taking trades that are losing your money. It's far better to make zero, zero, zero than lose a thousand, 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 whatever level you're playing at. It doesn't really matter. The point is, you get the idea. So using some kind of overbought, oversold condition that stops you from getting involved in oversold will stop you shorting right at those lows. Okay, number two, X from high filter. What do I mean by this? This could be a percentage, it could be pips, it could be ticks, could be whatever it is. You're basically saying, hey, if the market has moved a big distance from the recent swing high, that could be a high on a 15 minute if you're a day trader, a high on a daily, high on a weekly, whatever it may be. This is really more for day trading, so we'll go with that. 15 minute, 5 minute, whatever. The swings, the oscillations you get, looking at that and saying, hey, if we've moved more than 200, 150, whatever the kind of measurement should be for your chart, your trading, from the high, I'm not gonna go short. I'm gonna wait until we at least pull back a bit, or I'm just gonna wait until another phase of the market, i.e. some congestion happens or some reversal, some backfilling. I'm not gonna short if we've moved more than this in a specific kind of movement or wave. Or you can go broader and say in the day, you know, the day's got this much range. If we've already had this much range, I'm not gonna go short. That will stop you chasing those lows. And like I say, guys, sometimes chasing the lows will work well for you. If you have really brutal bear markets, really savage conditions, you can get away with it. But generally, you want to avoid this. Now, you can add some caveats to your plan and say, okay, I won't use these rules if these conditions, this condition is met, very strict conditions. Of course you can, but generally speaking, this will stop you getting caught on those short covering rallies and shorting too late and a bit of FOMO from the short side. All right, number three. A pretty broad one, but a very simple one is never short on a red day. Now, yes, you will, okay, some of you are going, ah, you're gonna miss out loads of stuff. I know your first red often is the first one out of many. I get it. But if you're having problems with this and you're getting caught out by this, a very easy, simple filter is, hey, I'm going short on green. I wanna see red first. You know, I wanna make sure I have my aggressive downtrend or whatever it may be, if I'm trading it that way, but I wanna see a green that I can short into for a push back down. Or if I think it's too high and we're kind of double topping, you know, this is obviously a different thing, it's not shorting into the hole, but that would be a completely separate strategy. But if we're shorting, we don't want to short right at those lows, wait for a green, whatever that may be. Even if it's on a time frame, a lower time frame, just waiting for that one green to close and saying, okay, now I'm allowed to look for my short. You might not necessarily short it on the close of the green, but at least it now opens the gate, if you like, takes the guard off the trigger and says, okay, I can short now, let me find a good entry for it. It stops you shorting at least on that low of that candle, the extreme. All right, number four, X percent or pips or ticks, that should be an S there, from the low trigger. In other words, similar as we were using X percent from the high as a filter to say, no, don't get involved at X percent from the high, you can flip it on its head and say, I will only get involved at X ticks or pips from the low. So you say, hey, you know what? If we move up more than 20 pips from the low, 50 pips, whatever it may be, now I can look for shorts, but it has to be above that. It's almost very similar to the green, and I put green day here, but that could be candle, actually, couldn't it? We've talked about it on a 15 minute or an hourly, whatever it may be, but you get the point. These two are very, very similar. You're basically allowing it to push back up before you can allow yourself to pull the trigger. So it stops you shorting rather low. You say, listen, I need to have at least an X percent pullback. And that number is going to be based on the move. If you've got a 500 pip move, you want a little bit more than 10 pip pullback, because that's just going to be noise. If you've got a kind of 100 pip move, then maybe 10, 15, 20 might be about right based on the gauge of the drive. So these just really simple rules, but the simplest rules are the best for stopping you overtrading. When it comes to overtrading, when it comes to, you know, chasing things, whether that be long or short, this one we're looking at specifically short, very simple rules to give you filters to not get involved in it are the best way by far of keeping you out of trouble. All right, guys, voiding shorting into the hole, those four rules. Let me know yours in the comment section below. And otherwise, good trading. Take care. Keep the risk managed however you do it. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.